Hi, this is Alex with Oneida Air Systems. Today we're going to be assembling the revolutionary Supercell Universal High Pressure Dust Collection System. We're going to be focusing on the 14-gallon freestanding cart configuration today. Now, these instructions apply for both the Supercell 1 and the Supercell Turbo. Let's do it. When you receive the Supercell, you'll receive the shipping pallet with multiple packed cardboard boxes. Always open and unpack the box labeled with the owner's manual first. Some components arrive in a high-density foam packing material designed to keep the Supercell secure and undamaged through the shipping process. It can be difficult to unpack. It should pull off with moderate amount of force applied. This video does not replace all content in the owner's manual and was designed to work in conjunction with the owner's manual. Please be sure to carefully read all safety information provided in the owner's manual before assembly and use of your Oneida Air Systems product. Do not turn on or plug in your dust collector until the installation is completed. Never run the system without the motor cowling in place. We suggest that when you unpack the Supercell, that you lay down the components on the cardboard packing boxes to prevent damage to the unit. Inspect the unit now for damages prior to assembly. Please contact our customer support team by visiting oneida-air.com/CST to complete a customer support request if you find any damages to your unit before assembly. Please confirm you have received each item listed in your owner's manual. Before putting together the Supercell, you'll need a number 2 Phillips head screwdriver, a 7/16 inch wrench, a 1/2 inch socket wrench, some channel lock pliers, a 3/8 inch wrench, a 7/16 inch socket wrench, a utility knife, and a 5/16 inch wrench. A drill with the appropriately sized socket driver can be used to speed up assembly. However, a threaded fastener should be started by hand to avoid accidental cross-threading of the bolt and nut. Also, a fastener should never be torqued down with a drill. The drill can be used to lightly snug the fastener in place, taking care to do final tightening of the fastener by hand with a wrench or socket driver to avoid under or over tightening of the fastener. Step 1. Insert the handle gasket into the handle's opening as shown and push it onto the stand body's handle so that it is fully covering the top edge. The handle gasket should be nested within the divots on each side of the handle. Repeat for both handles. Step 2. Insert 4 hex head bolts down through the threaded inserts on the stand body shown circled. These will protrude down from the stand body and help position the 14-gallon bin directly underneath the cyclone. Step 3. To install the bin gasket onto the stand body using the previously installed hex head bolts as a guideline, turn the stand body upside down. Lay out the 4 bin gasket segments. Do not remove the backer tape yet. Arrange the bin gasket segments in a circle, with the ends interlocking and aligning to the rounded front edge of the stand body. Carefully mark a circle around the inside of the arranged bin gasket segments with a marker to create a reference line. Peel the backer tape off of the bin gasket segments and adhere them to the stand body, lining them up with your reference line. We recommend removing the lid gasket's backing paper as you go rather than removing it all at once. Press each gasket piece firmly into the stand body to ensure a long-lasting, airtight seal. Step 4. Align the stand leg to the stand body, then secure using 4 carriage bolts, 4 washers, and 4 nylock nuts. Step 5. Align the latches onto the holes on either side of the stand body, and secure them in place using 2 panhead screws and nylock nuts. Firmly tighten this hardware. You may need to open the latch to access the screw holes for mounting. Allow for an additional 3 inches of clearance around the system for ease of access to the latches. Step 6. Secure the casters to the threaded insert on the bottom of each of the 4 stand legs. For ease of assembly, we recommend channel lock pliers to tighten the casters. Over-torquing can damage the connection point. Step 7. The cyclone's inlet can be rotated in 30-degree increments to best connect your ductwork and/or tools. Step 8. Place the flange gasket and the cyclone onto the stand body and align the hole patterns on all three items. Secure together using 6 hex head bolts, 6 flat washers, and 6 nylock nuts as shown. Make sure to install the hardware to the outer set of 6 holes, not the 8 notches, for proper alignment. Ensure that the nylock nuts are torqued down so that the gasket is firmly compressed. This will prevent air leaks. Step 9. Install the 4 hex head bolts, flat washers, rubber washers, and whizlock nuts to the holes in the cyclone's upper flange. Ensure that the whizlock nuts are torqued down so that the rubber washers are firmly compressed. This will prevent air leaks. Step 10. Place the filter on top of the cyclone with the open side facing down. Position the filter on the cyclone so that it is centered between all 4 hex head bolts. Step 11. Slide the filter hold down plate over the filter and the previously installed hex head bolts, and secure in place using 4 nylock nuts. Tighten hardware so that the filter's pre-installed foam gasket is firmly compressed by roughly 50%. Step 12. Open and slide the ring clamp over the assembly so that it rests outside the upper flange of the cyclone. Step 13. Using pliers, squeeze and open the double spring clamp and slip it onto the shorter end of the tubing assembly. Then, with the clamp still open, slide the tube assembly onto the vent tube near the cyclone's inlet, closing the spring clamp once the hose is fully seated. If you are not using the automatic bag holding feature of the system, the switch valve of the tube assembly must be in the closed position. Otherwise, leave the tube assembly in the open position. Step 14. Install the barrel gasket onto the rounded bottom edge of the motor assembly. We recommend you flip the motor assembly upside down for ease of installation of the barrel gasket. The barrel gasket should be oriented so that the rib side is facing upwards. The motor assembly is heavy and cumbersome. Be sure to have adequate help when lifting. Step 15. Carefully lift the motor assembly up and over the filter and down onto the cyclone's upper flange. Align the motor assembly so its perimeter is flush with the cyclone's flange below it. The motor assembly can be freely rotated to best position the magnetic starter and pulse bar to suit your needs. Some positions will not work as these items may impact with the wall. Step 16. Lift and close the ring clamp over the barrel gasket and the cyclone's upper flange. Secure the ring clamp using the clamp's cotter pin. Step 17. Take the tubing assembly and route it through the closest retaining hole located in the back corner of the stand body. Which hole you use will be determined by the orientation of your motor assembly. Use whichever hole is closest to ensure adequate length for the tubing assembly to connect to the drum. Step 18. Connect the dust sentry's power adapter to the dust sentry cord on the motor assembly's magnetic starter. The dust sentry's strobe light should be mounted in a highly visible area using adhesive strips or the 2 mounting holes. Refer to the dust sentry installation sheet or our in-depth assembly video for more information. Discard your dust sentry's 110-volt power cable if you are using the power cable attached to the magnetic starter. The dust sentry's location is limited by the 2 wires extending from the strobe light and must have sufficient length to install in the pre-cut hole on the stand body. Step 19. Install the dust sentry's infrared sensor to the pre-cut hole on the stand body. If you are not using the dust sentry, the button plug must be installed. Step 20. Install the quick disconnect kit onto the pre-drilled hole near the bottom section of the drum. Refer to the quick disconnect installation sheet for more information. If you are not using the automatic bag holding feature of the system, the valve of the tube assembly must be in the closed position. Step 21. Take each of the 5 casters and thread them into the holes located underneath the drum. Step 22. Place a liner bag inside the drum. Take care to ensure that the bag is fully expanded to the inside of the drum and that the upper edge of the liner bag is folded out and over the lip of the drum. Step 23. Attach the long end of the tube assembly onto the nylon elbow installed on the lower section of the drum. Push the hose onto the fitting so that all barbs are covered. Step 24. Center the drum assembly underneath the stand assembly and lower the latches so that they hook underneath the rim of the drum. The latches can then be closed to lift the drum up from the ground and seal the dust collector for operation. Be sure to rotate the drum to ensure that you can easily see the pre-installed fill viewing window. The hex head bolts installed in step 2 are guides for positioning the drum during latching. The back rim of the drum should be in light contact with both hex head bolts as the drum is lifted up and latched. Step 25. Uncoil and hang the antenna extension wire either on the ceiling or high up on the wall. See our in-depth explainer video on how to optimize your remote control performance with the antenna wire. Almost there. Hook up your flex hose or ductwork to the inlet of the supercell and hook up the other end of the ductwork or hose to your tools. Plug in and turn on the dust collector, and that's it. Now you're ready to collect some dust. If you have any questions or experience difficulty with your supercell, contact our customer support team by visiting oneida-air.com/CST to complete a customer support request. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.